When I first started making music, then it was when I was about 9 years old. My father had a home studio for his country band, and sometimes I would sneak in and record songs. I made this like goth Casio music and sang like a little boy. Then as I grew up, I just always wrote songs and music, but never really showed anyone. It wasn't until a few years ago that I did. And only recently did I really believe in the music I was making. That's, I think, why I'm finally releasing music into the world. I've used Bandcamp and YouTube and so on to get my music out there, but I never really pushed it. I always want it to catch on naturally. I never want to force my music on people. So yeah, if you follow, I'll always post updates on what I'm doing, at least for now. But if someone's not interested, they don't have to follow. But it's helpful for someone like me who's generally quite hermetic in personality, or you can call it shy, maybe. I don't have any intentions of hiding behind the internet, but I do try to use it in an artistic way, like anything else. And I do play live shows and push myself to bring the music in a very old school, real way. As I started recording The Grime and the Glow, Pendu approached me about releasing an album, and it was good timing. Also, I liked their aesthetic and description of their roster, like Rippers, Creepers, Night Terrors, and Cosmic Blizzards. It made sense to me and felt aligned with my own vision for that album. I wanted to make something that captured different spaces and moods. The word in Greek has multiple meanings. It can refer to end times or the end of an era, but it also translates to revelations or lifting of the veil, the truth being revealed. For me, there's a grand vision in my mind for this word. I have a lot of apocalyptic dreams, and I got really inspired for these songs by reading the Book of Revelations, and also reading The Fountainhead and Atlas Shrugged, which to me are very apocalyptic and idealistic and grand. Apocalypse was actually recorded after The Grime and the Glow, but I guess timing doesn't matter. I like to go back and forth between sounds and genres and experiment with new things. I think of music in a very visual way, so I try to make songs like a movie soundtrack, like something that will not just sound like a song, but will feel like a song behind your eyes. I try to write music in an instinctual way. I'm self-taught, and I listen for hidden sounds and notes in the music that find their way in and make it something new and different. I do like drone and repetition and incorporating a sense of chanting into the music, even if it does have a pop structure or feel to it. And I wanted to record it myself as to have control over all the haunted sounds that creep in. Not mistakes, but sounds that become trapped. There are people I've recorded with before that want to get rid of all those special sounds, but I think they're vital and important. Maybe it's because when I was little, I had a haunted keyboard. I had this keyboard that recorded its own version of one of my songs. It was a dark and beautiful harmonic version. Made me appreciate these hauntings, even if it's something really dark, it's real too. I don't think of myself as a very good storyteller, maybe just an observer and someone who's in the background trying to dig up the truth. But I've always written things down in a way that I can understand them. When I was younger, I mostly wrote poetry, but now I always use the words for songs. Same things that have always inspired me still inspire me now. The dark side of the world. As I mentioned, I wanted to record the album myself so I could capture the special sounds that come through the electricity and the hiss of the tape, the human voice echoing in different spaces and so on. I recorded songs with different friends and some of them by myself. It was a great mix of different people, different places and mindsets, but the songs were meant to be together. Suppose it's something like the way the spiritual realm interacts with everyday material human life. The character of death looms over us, and it's not necessarily a bad thing, but something to be explored. People explore it in many different ways, and maybe one can become obsessed with it or possessed by it. Well, some of my ideas about the end times are very scientific. Imagining a solar flare so powerful that Earth turns into an uninhabitable burning sphere. But I also know that eventually the oil age is going to end, and if things keep going the way they are now, it will only lead to more war, more greed, more insanity. The post-industrial stone age, the end of the dark American dream. I don't mean to sound paranoid, I actually feel very intrigued by all of this, although it's quite depressing at its root. I just have felt very nostalgic for simple living, almost nostalgic for the Depression era in the US. I've been listening to a lot of music lately from the 1920s and 30s and 40s. Sometimes when I'm at a store buying something and I see my hand giving over a small green piece of paper in exchange for goods, feel so alien, and I think maybe I'm living in a dream world and my eyes are just hazed over. Obviously, totally untrained in the area of video making, but that's why I love it. Just using the small tools I have to make something. I love Ingmar Bergman and think of him more as an inspiration for my music than videos, but yes, the filmmakers that have influenced my music, like Bergman, David Lynch, Corey McCabe, and also old footage of industrial era Russia and depression era America influenced my sense of visuals in a video format. I used to work at a play theater, so I had access to great costumes and strange sets. For this, I found a great old wedding dress with beautiful sleeves and used this set that was supposed to be a spaceship. It was kind of perfect. My boss wore the costume and danced like a snake charmer. Futurist is actually a perfect word. It's not that I want the video or videos to be boring per se. I just don't like when things are too easy, like flash, flash. The world craves things to be fast and easy these days, and kind of want to go against that sometimes and make something slow and almost a bit painful. Wild Eyes is the doom pop project I have with Ben Chisholm of White Horse. He plays the Juno synths and piano in my band, and he's a great producer and remixer as well. Together, we're kind of making these dark, shadowy songs that are electronic-based and maybe sort of dancey. We use samples and synths and real drums. For me, it's fun to not use guitar, which is usually my main accompaniment while I'm writing songs. Wild Eyes has a full album almost ready, but we don't have specific plans to release it quite yet. Russian Karaoke is the title of my next album that I'm currently working on. This album will have kind of a quiet passion exploring different ways to use certain instruments and sounds that's new to me. I think the similarity to the grime and the glow will be the back and forth between having some songs with full instrumentation and some that are more stripped down, but it definitely has a different quality to it. I wouldn't call it clean, but something more like sparkling. When you step